And welcome. Thank you for your time. I know you are quite fired up about this issue. How on earth can Murray Allen get a report that says there's no Indigenous culture, no artefacts, nothing found on the land, his land that he wants to build on, but he still can't get approval?
I know, Peter. Thanks so much for having me on. I am fired up about this. I think what people need to understand is that we are facing a risk to all private property owners. If this goes through, and at the moment I might say it's sitting with Tanya Plibersek, and right up front I'm saying I'm urging her, I've written to her, urging her to stop this going through. Murray and Marie's land has been cultural heritage annexed, and it has gone into their property from Lake Tyrrell suddenly out of the blue. What we need to understand, the background to this is that the state and federal government have put in $4 million to build a beautiful viewing platform and over Lake Tyrrell itself. So it actually sits out over the water. Murray and Marie's property is right next door, 400 metres back from the perimeter of the boundary, which sits near Lake Tyrrell. They have spent $500,000 so far in approved plans for roads, water and power. They have also been required to spend a further $33,000 getting cultural heritage approvals. They put in a plan to the Andrews government that was knocked back by Barangaroo Gadjin Land Council, who were requesting that. And now five Aboriginal heritage applicants have written to Tanya Plibersek asking her to annex Murray and Marie's property so that they can build their own tourist event in that space or nearby that space. So, if on any other terms, this would be anti-competitive behaviour, but now we've got it as Aboriginal heritage law. It is deeply disturbing, and I really hope that Tanya Plibersek says no.
Hey, I'm thrilled to hear that you've taken up the fight for Murray in Canberra. I'm out of time. I'm going to leave it there. But can you please stay in touch so we can follow it? I had a huge response to this story on Monday and want to stay across it for my viewers. Thank you, Anne.